ఈరోజు ఈ నేషనల్ బుక్ ట్రస్ట్ ఇక్కడ చేసిన ఈ కార్యక్రమం చాలా ఒక మహత్వపూర్ణ ఒక కార్యక్రమం, గొప్ప కార్యక్రమం. హైదరాబాద్ లో ఎప్పుడు కూడా ఒక ప్రతి సంవత్సరం ఒక బుక్ ఫెయిర్ జరిగేది అక్కడ, కానీ 10 సంవత్సరం తర్వాత ఈ నేషనల్ బుక్ ట్రస్ట్ వాళ్ళు ఇక్కడ ఈ కార్యక్రమం ఏర్పాటు చేసింది, మాకు చాలా సంతోషం. సికందర్ గారికి చాలా ధన్యవాదాలు మా గురించి. అసతో మా సత్యమయ, తమసో మా జ్యోతిర్గమయ, అంటే ఫ్రమ్ ఇగ్నరెన్స్ టు నాలెడ్జ్ అండ్ డార్క్నెస్ టు లైట్, ఇదే దిస్ ఇస్ ద మెయిన్ పర్పస్ ఆఫ్ బుక్స్ అండ్ రీడింగ్ బుక్స్, బికాస్ ఇట్ రిమూవ్స్ ద వెయిల్ ఆఫ్ ఇగ్నరెన్స్ అండ్ బ్రింగ్స్ అస్ ఫ్రమ్ డార్క్నెస్ అండ్ టు లైట్. దట్ ఇస్ ద మెయిన్ పర్పస్. బట్ ఆఫ్ లేట్ దిస్ హ్యాబిట్ హెస్ రియలీ సఫర్డ్. వై హ్యాస్ ఇట్ సఫర్డ్? వి నీడ్ టు లుక్ ఇన్ టు దట్. ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ దట్ దెర్ ఇస్ ద షార్టేజ్ ఆఫ్ బుక్స్, బట్ దెర్ ఆర్ అదర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్. ఇఫ్ మై డియర్ టెలివిజన్ brethren will pardon me for saying this, probably the invasion of the television has to a great impact on book reading. It's much easier sitting down and seeing something very sensational on the television than reading a book. That becomes a lazy habit. So I think if the televisions also can go into more analytical programs, then probably people will again go back to the book reading habit. And I entirely agree with Jilani Banu Amgaru when she said book reading should start from the children's stage, from the school stage. Book reading should be encouraged even for school students. Appure that becomes a habit malli pedvala athi athi adetla ante pannukone mundo eppunaga okka sari oka half an hour 15 minutes aina book reading chesthe chaala manthi alavata aa alavata modat nunche manam pillaliki theeskoravalanu kabatti kada pedala naatlanti itla pedala ayin tarvata ippudu chadavalante chaala kashtam kaani meer pillal nunchi start chesante school children start chesante aa alavata atlane undipothadu malli enta kattane undipothadu. So I would request all parents, please encourage your children to get into the book reading habit from the very initial stages. I am in fact very thankful to Mr. Sikandar that he has decided to organize a book promotion center in Hyderabad. I do not know, I am saying it out of ignorance, whether we can think in terms of a mobile library concept. Mobile library, which in those days, for example, in many places I have known of the mobile libraries which go from colony to colony, and children and elders gather around and pick up books, and thereafter after a week or 10 days they return the whole book to the same library. If you can think of the mobile libraries which can go into areas or colonies, that probably will improve our book reading habit in one way. The other concept that I would like to talk of is cafe reading. You know, many of our youngsters like to go into the cafe, maybe some small little joint where they can have a cup of coffee, where they spend 45 minutes, 1 hour, 2 hours, etc. If some sort of books can be kept there, which can be made available for free reading, you will find that many of the youngsters will probably prefer to go to the cafe, and while they're having a pizza or having a whatever, their coffee or a chat, they will also keep reading some books. Many people are tempted to go and do this free reading in cafes. This does exist in some places where you can go to a hotel, to a cafe, sit there for about an hour. You order for one cup of coffee, which probably will cost you 20 or 30 rupees, but read a book which is read, and then you keep coming at frequent intervals and carry on with that book reading. This is the concept which we could probably try in some of the leading cafes in Hyderabad. This probably will help many of our younger college students and other students to probably frequent the cafe, because cafes are always very crowded. It is not that any cafe is, be it the pizza corner or be it the whichever corner it is, it's always very crowded. So we could probably think in terms of this concept of having books, book reading in the cafes, which can be free, which means somebody has to sort of subsidize those people, because that means the people are going to spend a long time. But you can tell them, all right, you can't be sitting in a table. You can have a corner where they can pick up a book and read, and then come back to the table where they're going to have coffee, so that the customers keep moving. And there'll be some people at least who will take to this reading habit. This is something which we can look at. The other problem is cheaper books. Books are very expensive. And if we can look to more paperbacks, because, you know, many people like to relax and read a book. Holding a hard-bound copy and reading becomes very difficult, that because many people like to read at the end of the day. For example, people like me, well, I would like to probably read at the end of the day, relax on a bed and read it. But holding a hard book and reading becomes very difficult, because you can't even turn the pages. Probably more of paperbacks and more inexpensive books, cheaper books. Because what happens is, when you think in terms of buying a book, you think at the cost twice, and that becomes a major problem. With all this book reading that we have put into this thing, well, certainly it's supposed to bring in a lot of wisdom. and it's supposed to make us more educative, more educated. And what really separates us from others, from the primates, is basically the Homo sapiens have taken to the reading habit. That is the major, this thing.